empty restaurants, empty promises, empty stores, empty school, and empty pockets, and a great big why. There are articles and rumors about the gas station at the Lighthouse Circle.
But what I don't understand about the situation at the gas station is that for 10 years, he was issued a mercantile license to continue to conduct business, and nothing was ever done for 10 years about the structures. And I'm sure someone in the city knew about them. And I was just wondering why now, after all that time, and costing the business owner tens of thousands of dollars in whatever fees he incurred due to this whole process. So why did it take so long, and now all of a sudden? I guess that's just the answer I'm looking for.
Those sheds did withstand Sandy. They have been there a long time. I know the owner. When I spoke to him, Dave said he has no problem bringing them up to code. The question is, up to what code? But it was said that our ordinances do not prevent that shed from being there. He's not moving to that other property voluntarily. He's doing it because he has to, because he does not have the monies in order to potentially bring the property up to code, the full property, because he is under the impression that once he starts digging a foundation, which he was told he needs, that once he digs into the ground, he has to upscale the entire property, which is a lot of money he does not have. And from what I see, and I was told by his engineering firm, and I believe even our engineering firm, said a D variance, I believe it was said, could be issued to him. So can we work together here to keep him on that property? I've talked to a lot of parties involved. I've looked at paperwork. I do want to say that there's a little bit of discrepancy here as to whether or not he was taken off the agenda there, I guess a day or two before it was supposed to happen. Now, that being said, I know it's been drug out. Again, being the third ward councilman, I'm trying to step into a situation where the constituents are very concerned on the whole island. Between both of our auto suppliers, if you will. And I think right now, we seriously need to look into whether or not there are ordinances being broken there. I understand about inspection. I understand the code. I understand, you know, that's where Rich Stevens comes in and he makes a call as an inspector. I understand that the planning board makes a call on the D variances. However, I don't think everybody's working together here and seeing the bigger picture of keeping a viable business there where it's located. He does not want to leave that property voluntarily, and I do think there are some things here, right, we need to look at. It seems to me, because I looked over the ordinance, the shed versus building a foundation.
It's not our reconsideration at this level unless we're willing to change the zoning ordinance.
No, it's not any ordinance. That's my point. The ordinance does...
There are auxiliary buildings and structures are in the ordinance.
From what I understand, and again,
and
there's Pongio Engineering and Dixon Engineering, and the lawyers submitted the plan. They looked through our ordinance, and from what they say, two engineering firms, it's been there for some time. What's done is done. It's been inspected by people in our city for some time. I do feel like it's my responsibility to speak up for somebody who doesn't feel like he has a voice, is frustrated, and withdrew only because he spent so much money and he's given up.
From what
it
sounds,
it is my responsibility to step up.
And
I'd like Andy to speak on this, because recently I saw a picture of him with Dave on Facebook. But we do have some influence in this city. That's why we're here, to do right by the constituents. If we move forward as a body and ask everybody to reconsider, look into it, to keep a man in business who's been servicing this city for so long and doing a lot of favors. I've been there. I've spoken to Ed. I've spoken to Dave. I've spoken to some other people involved. Again, I'm asking us to, as a group and as a city and as a council and as a planning board and as a city manager, to work with somebody, because the next question I want to ask is, have we worked with anybody else in the past in these types of issues? It's been brought to my attention by people. There are other issues in this town where these same things have happened, whether it's before, pre, or post permit, and we have worked with people. There are sheds. There are storage facilities at other businesses. There are other variances that have been given even next door to him recently with the Larragosa. There are a lot of variances that have been given and leeway given. Days before, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I was going to show up there.
It was not days before the meeting. It was days before the deadline, early in the month, to get on the agenda for that end of the month meeting. So it was at least 3 weeks before.
Can I ask you, I mean, I could be wrong, and if I'm wrong, I apologize to the public, but I believe I was going to be down here for that meeting. And so were a lot of other people. And it was literally a couple days before. We were told, don't go, because it's not going to be an agenda. Now, that means either somebody got the phone call and whoever forgot to tell everybody not to be there for 3 weeks, or it was a couple days before Dave and his lawyer got the phone call stating you're no longer on the agenda. Somebody's wrong here. Somebody's wrong here with their dates. Because I know up until a few days before, I was going to be there, too, to hear what was going on. Okay. And I do want to go on record saying, when I met with Ed, you were very thorough about it. You explained your concerns. I understand that and the safety of those. What I'm here to say is, all Dave wanted to do up until now, tell him what to do to make him safe, he'll make him safe. And I know that was with, you know, with Rich Stevens and inspection. However, again, when I started my statement, it was about whether or not they come down, foundation has to be built, which brings in a whole nother thing, or whether or not the shed could be there. Dave's attorneys and engineers have said our ordinance allows for that shed to be there the way it is if we get a D variance, strictly for the 5-foot setback. That's all I'm saying. If that shed can be there with that 5-foot setback, with a D variance for that, because it's only inches right now, do we go ahead and allow him to upgrade that shed and use it for what he needs to use it for? His engineering firm, our engineering firm, apparently, the Ponzio Dickinson and his attorney are questioning where in our ordinance can we enforce something that's not in our ordinance. I'm asking you, is it in our ordinance that he can't do that? And if so, who's saying it is?
Okay, you must know the ordinance inside and out.
Okay, anyone else want to? Mr. Yeah. Simpson, you asked
him. Yeah, hate to get back on the gas station thing, but I heard on a radio talk host show come up going into work that Brigantine is going to only have one gas station. John Withers said that I was had a picture of myself with him with Dave DeFanction, which I known practically his whole life, and his brother John. Somebody asked me to come down. Dave wanted to take a picture. He goes, I don't want to take a picture with you, but I'll take a picture with Andy Simpson. I got out of my office at the Dole Century 21 building and came down and took a picture with Dave. Had a conversation with him on the side, you know. Wished him well. Anything I could do for him, I'm there for him. We even talked about his big 5-ton truck that he helps the city out with the snow and Superstorm Sandy and all that. Mike made arrangements with Ed to be able to park the 5-ton truck on one of our commercial properties. So, city's working with him. I'm definitely working with him. He's been a friend. There's no animosity against Dave DeFanction, John DeFanction, or any DeFanction I know.
Andy, you made a comment that Dave asked you to go down there to take a photo with you. I want to ask you, because I had just put up 2 political signs in the morning, and an hour later, I'm getting a phone call that one of my political signs was taken down. And miraculously, yourself and a few Republican running mates ended up down there within an hour taking a photo op. So I do not believe that Dave called you down there. Somehow or another, you guys ended up down there. The photo was taken, and I believe, if I'm not mistaken, it's my personal opinion, that with my 2 political signs I put up there, it wasn't liked, You guys showed up, took mine down, put yours up, took a photo op. It, something just doesn't seem right there.
I don't know if this is something we want to talk about at a council meeting. But, I mean, this is not really...
I just want to clear that up.
It's not really council business.
I will tell you, he's right, because I witnessed it, and I was there, and I saw Andy there with three of his Republican candidates running, and it wasn't a nice situation, what I witnessed and what I saw, and some of the threatening remarks and comments I heard coming from some of them.
Well, and there were other people that witnessed it.
I witnessed it. I was there.
You know, once again,
I just had to add on
to that. This is not something that should be a topic at council.
It was brought up by constituent. I kept my comments to Dave as a business person to shed the foundation.
Well, the location of signs.
That's what I kept my comments to.
I don't think the location of signs was brought up by a constituent.
But well, the fact that Andy said he went down there because Dave asked him to go down there, I take exception to that.
I don't care what you take exception
to,
John.
All right. You're right. It's a coincidence that you guys scheduled a photo op right after I put my signs up.
The gentleman called me, asked me to come down and take a picture with Dave. I said, you sure Dave wants me there? And he goes, yes. I went down there. I didn't drag him over to the sign and everything else. So we took a photograph. Then I went and talked to him off to the side. Lisa walked up. I said, give me a few minutes. Me and Dave are talking right now. Lisa left. I don't know what happened after that. And I had a conversation with Dave. And that was it. You know.
And your political sign went up and picture went on Facebook.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
So I'm not here playing any political games. I'm calling people out that are playing political games. Okay.
Well. You know, once again, this is a council meeting, and elections should be separate from that.
You're absolutely right.
And that's one of the reasons I was a little uncomfortable with it.
I wish everybody here was down the middle of the road and doing the best for Brigantine.